Welcome everyone to my presentation. In this presentation, I will describe an early stage of a study that aims to provide guidelines for developing the VR program in residential aged care. Research shows that there are some benefits of VR in aged care. It can enable all those to engage in activities that they can no longer easily do in the real world, such as global travel. It also helps all those to reduce their apathy and helps them feel less socially isolated. Several residential aged care facilities have recently piloted VR in their homes. Despite these benefits, there has been low uptake of VR among those. Research shows that staff need to be on board as facilitators and to encourage uptake. However, their views on VR have not been comprehensively studied, so this study aims to address this gap by surveying residential aged care staff. We conducted a comprehensive literature review regarding the use of technology and particularly the use of VR in residential aged care. However, there is still lack of information regarding staff views on which characteristic of residents would not be suitable for the VR program, what change should be made in terms of VR devices and applications, what training should be provided for staff members. These questions need to be addressed to have the adoption of VR in residential aged care facilities achieve a greater likelihood of success. In this research, we have partnered with an aged care provider that has recently purchased VR headsets for use across their facilities. Open-ended questions were used to survey staff members. The survey has been distributed to residential aged care staff who have been involved in the VR program through the Qualtrics platform. Data collected has been subjected to simple descriptive analysis. The research has been conducted in accordance with the ethical standards approved by the University of Melbourne Human Research Ethics Committee. There have been 10 responses from lifestyle coordinators. The respondents have been coded as from AAC 1 to AAC 10. The respondents point out that the VR program is beneficial for residents in terms of helping them calm down, reduce boredom, increase happiness, and providing new and enjoyable experience. Notably, according to the respondent, VR could be helpful for pain management, which can help residents divert attention from pain to the experience. Regarding the research questions, which characteristics of residents would not be suitable for the VR program? According to the survey respondents, residents with clinical conditions, cognitive issues, and dementia would not be suitable for the VR program. When it comes to the research questions, what change should be made in terms of VR devices and applications? The survey respondents suggested that the head-mounted display devices need to be lighter, simpler, and adjustable because they are currently too heavy, tight, and make residents feel uncomfortable. Concerning the VR experience, respondents suggested that more travel and different countries' videos should be more available for use. Another notable aspect related to the technology is that Wi-Fi connection within the aged care home needs to be improved. In terms of the research questions, what training should be provided for staff? According to the survey respondents, more ongoing and updating of VR use training should be provided for residential aged care staff who have been involved in the VR program in the home. Furthermore, the knowledge of benefits and drawbacks of VR should be equipped for staff so that they can understand exactly about the VR technology. Following on the participants' responses, we made some recommendations for developing the VR program in residential aged care as well. Adopting VR devices and applications to aged care residents, conducting more co-design of VR for body devices and applications, investigating technological infrastructure within the aged care homes, enhancing digital literacy and facilitation skills for staff members, developing a library of useful and workable applications, and creating an online forum for staff members to discuss their experience. So that's all for my presentation today. Thank you for your attention.